Okay, so hello everyone, considering that I've just recently replaced the bearings on this single phase dual capacitor induction motor, I figured I might as well show you a video on how to troubleshoot and check for yourself whether the motor is still good or not. So I had to replace the bearings because this was flooded too. I already checked it and cleaned it up, but when it ran, it's noisy. Okay, I'll show you. Going to turn that on. So you see, that was before and this is how it runs now. See? A lot smoother, a lot quieter. So in this video, I'll show you how to check everything, okay? The running winding, starting capacitor and running capacitor, as well as the centrifugal switch. That's why I made this wiring diagram, just so you will have a basic understanding of how everything is connected, okay? So if we look at here, we have U1, U2, Z1, Z2, and another Z1. So on our diagram, U1, U2, Z1, Z2, Z1. So it's on U1 and U2 that we need to connect our plug. Now be advised, this is just a simpler version of what's inside here, okay? Like I've said, just so you'll have a basic understanding. Now if you see U1 and U2, okay, this U1 and U2, this is our running winding, okay? See that connected here, you have your winding here, and then it goes back here. And this, we have this jumper, okay, in order to connect U1 to Z1, U2 to Z2. And the only reason why we have Z1 here, okay, you see that? That is only a jumper. See? Just to connect it from here to here. And the only reason why we have that is, if you have this in this orientation, the motor is going to turn clockwise. However, if you move this, okay, like so, the motor is going to turn counterclockwise. So don't be confused. The only purpose we have Z1 is just so we can reverse the rotation of the motor. Okay, so we'll just focus here, Z1 and Z2 now. Now Z1 and Z2, okay, we have this winding. This is connected here, and then it protrudes outwards towards the back of the electric motor. Same on Z1, you have that winding, and then the end protrudes also on the back of the motor. I'll show you. Let me take this off. So you see these two wires? It's the same, okay? Winding, protruding outwards. Again, winding, protruding outwards. Follow? So this is our starting winding. So out of these two wires, one is connected here, you see, and this is connected to the centrifugal switch. So we will connect this to our centrifugal switch, okay? And take note, this is our running capacitor. This is also connected. One wire is connected, okay? I'll mark it in blue. Just the same on our capacitor so that you won't be confused. One wire from our running capacitor is also connected to the centrifugal switch. The other wire from our running capacitor is connected to our starting winding, okay? And here, okay, on the other side of our motor is our starting capacitor. And our starting capacitor, okay, also in blue, one wire is connected to the other side of the centrifugal switch, okay? And the other wire, which is this one, okay, in brown, is connected to our starting winding as well as the running capacitor. And this is our centrifugal switch, okay? Typically, it's closed, like so, connecting this and this, okay? Close. Let me take the fan out as well as the centrifugal switch cover, okay? Just so I can show you much better. Now, just a piece of advice, especially if you're new at this, I would suggest before you take anything apart or disconnect anything, take a picture of it first, okay, or a video even. That way, when you need to put it back together, you will have a reference. So I'll take the fan out. I'll remove the centrifugal switch cover. Okay, one, two. Let me move that out of the way without disconnecting anything. So like I've said, your centrifugal switch is typically closed, connecting this to this, okay? And this is towards your starting capacitor. So here to here towards your starting capacitor. So as you plug the motor in, current is gonna flow towards the starting capacitor. And this will induce the rotor to turn. And so as this turns, centrifugal force is going to cause this centrifugal switch to be pulled back, okay? Disconnecting the, see, centrifugal switch. See that? Okay, let me illustrate. It is something like this, okay? As I will turn it, it is pushed outwards. So that is how this thing essentially works, and that will disconnect the centrifugal switch, in turn disconnecting the starting capacitor. Because as the name itself suggests, the starting capacitor is only needed during initial startup of the induction motor. As the rotor is already turning, this will disengage, disconnecting the starting capacitor, and then the running capacitor just takes over, continuing the rotation. That's why it's called running capacitor. So this is essentially how everything is connected inside your dual capacitor single phase induction motor. So if we understand all this, checking this should be easy, okay? And that's what we'll do next. That's why we need to perform three tests: continuity test, resistance test, and capacitance test. So continuity test, okay, this one is just to see whether the line is not broken, meaning it's continuous, okay, and it should beep. And resistance test is just to see how much resistance there is on the line, see? So I would suggest before you even bother to check the motor, check your input line first, meaning the plug that you connect to U1 and U2. A lot of times, they tend to skip this part. But as far as I'm concerned, this is very important because this is your input line towards your electric motor. Let me show you, okay? Say, for example, this is our input line, okay? Of course, this is not because this thinner wire, but just for illustration, check for continuity as well as resistance, okay? So let's check. Let's try this one. And as you can see, it's beeping, but it's got a high resistance, 9.3 ohms. Let's check the other one. So it's beeping, but it's only got a resistance of 1.6 ohms, meaning this wire, okay, is already bad because they should have equal, see, they should have equal resistance. In this case, this one is already bad. And this is oftentimes the cause when you see your wires burning, okay? Should this be connected to a power tool? And then you see this while you're using your power tool, and then you see this burn because it has already a high resistance in somewhere in its line. So now we can move on to check our running winding, if it's continuous, as well as the resistance, okay? Do something like that, and it should beep. Let's move towards here. Now be advised, okay, before you check this, make sure to remove the jumper, okay? Otherwise you might have erroneous results. So we want to isolate U1 and U2 only, okay? So let's check, and it's beeping. That means the line is continuous and we only have a resistance of 2.6 ohms. If, for example, you do not hear a beep, okay, or the resistance is higher, that means somewhere along its winding, the line is already broken if you do not hear a beep, or if you have a higher resistance, like I've shown earlier with the wire, that means somewhere along its winding is already burned. That's why it's causing a much higher resistance. So in this case, we only have 2.6 and that's good. So now let's move on to check the starting winding Z1 and Z2. And in order for us to do that better, we must first disconnect this running capacitor as well as the, hold on, starting capacitor as well as this one, okay? That way we can isolate only the starting winding. So let me remove this. Let me disconnect this one too, okay? So see, two wires out of the motor. So let's first check this, okay, connected here, and then let's check this connected here. Then we will connect these two, and let's check here, okay? I'll show you. So let's start with Z1 first. Okay, it's beeping, meaning it's continuous, and we have a resistance of 2.7 ohms. And should we check Z2, it should have an equal resistance, okay? More or less also 2.7. And we're right on the money, so. Meaning equal resistance, there's nothing wrong with our winding. Now the next check that we'll need to do is to connect one probe on Z1 and the other on Z2 and connect these two. And it's continuous and we have a resistance of 4.6. So that's good. So we have equal resistance on each, okay, Z1 and Z2, 2.7, and that's good. Just remember the starting winding always has a higher resistance than the running winding. Now that was continuity test, okay? The wonderful thing about this is that not only does it check continuity, it also provides for resistance. But there is a slight deviation in result, okay? Let me show you. See, 2.3, if we will put that only on purely resistance, see, 2.0 ohms, U1 and U2. So remember, like I said, the running winding has a lower resistance than the starting winding. So 2.0 ohms only. So again, let's check Z1 and Z2. Z1 first. 2.2 ohms. Okay, 2.1. Here, 2.2 ohms. 2.1 ohms. Okay, again, connect one probe on Z1 and one on Z2, we should have more or less 4 ohms or 4.2 ohms. So 4.1 ohms. So our running winding is good. Our starting winding is good as well. Okay? Like I've shown earlier with this wire, if this or this has a higher resistance or does not beep, that means there's something wrong with the winding. Or like I've shown here, if one does not show equal resistance, also there's problem with the winding. Now, although we use a jumper to connect the running winding as well as the starting winding, we only want that connected through here, okay, or here, but not inside the stator body. That's why in order to confirm that, we need to also check this, like so, and that should not beep. Should it beep, that means the running winding and starting winding are coming into contact with each other, because it should only come into contact through, like I've said, through this jumper and not inside the stator body. So continuity test is beeping and it should not beep, okay? It should not beep. Like so, okay? So, good. Because like I've said, if that will beep, meaning the running winding as well as the starting winding are shorted out. And if that's the case, you need to rewind the motor. Now we need to check if the windings, okay, both running and starting windings are grounded with the stator, okay? And we do not want that, so. Stator, one probe on the stator body and one probe here, 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 as well as here, here, and it should not beep. So let me remove the rotor first, just so I can show you much better. Let me disconnect these two. Let me tap this. Okay. Pull the rotor out. Okay, so new bearings. Okay, so you see that? Although these windings are all mesh inside there, but these windings, see, those insulations should not come into contact with the stator body or the body of the motor itself, okay? Put probes here, and it's beeping, as you can hear. I will leave one probe on the stator and then check U1, U2, Z1, as well as Z2. Check also here. Okay, it's not beeping, and that's good. In any event, should you hear that beep, that means the windings are coming into contact with the stator, and that's dangerous. That's why there are times when you touch the electric motor when it's running, you feel a ground or you get electrocuted. Now, be advised, as far as I'm concerned, you don't actually have to remove the rotor in order to do that check. You really need not put the probes on the stator body in order to perform that checks like I've shown earlier, okay? Any part of the electric motor, for so long as it's bare metal, you see that, okay? Not here because it's painted, see? Even if I'll touch here, see, that's continuous, see? And that's continuous. So you can only just put it here and then perform that checks here, see? So far so good. There's no problem with our running winding and starting winding, and it's not coming into contact with the stator body as well as the motor body, okay? Now let's move on to checking our capacitor, running capacitor, starting capacitor. So in order to check our running capacitor, we need to take the capacitor out of this case because we need to take a look at its value. Okay. So let's start with this one. This is our running capacitor. Now always remember, because this is a dual capacitor motor, the capacitor with the lower capacitance is the running capacitor. The capacitor with the higher capacitance is the starting capacitor. So let's take a look at the value. We have 30 microfarad plus or minus 5%. So get yourself a calculator, 30 plus or minus 5%. So meaning 30 times 0.05, 1.5. So plus or minus 1.5. So 30 microfarad plus or minus 5% is equals to 1.5. Meaning, should we check this, we should only see a value of between 28.5 to 31.5, 30 plus or minus 5%, okay? So put your multimeter on the capacitance test. See? Now, before you check this, you need to discharge the capacitor because this is somewhat like a battery, okay? It has a charge, you need to discharge it. Just short it like so. Okay. Let's check. It doesn't matter, doesn't have polarity, which probe you use, okay? Now, we have a reading of 31.1 microfarad. So, well within specs, between 28.5 to 31.5. So, we have a 31.1. Okay, so this is good. Now, this is the starting capacitor, 300 plus or minus 10%. So, again, get your calculator, 300 times 0.10. So, meaning 300 plus or minus 30. So 300 plus or minus 10% is equals to 30, meaning we are only looking for a value between 270 to 330, okay? Anything more than that or anything less than that, meaning the capacitor is already no longer good. So again, just like the running capacitor, before we check this, discharge it first. Just short it out like so. So again, let's check. So that is 351, and that is beyond 330, okay? Because like I've said, it should only be between 270 to 330. In this case, that is 340, okay? 350. So the value that we have is 350. So meaning this capacitor is already out of spec. So in time, maybe I will replace this, but still I can use this because like I've explained earlier, the starting capacitor is only active during startup of the induction motor. Once the rotor starts turning, this already disengages. So in time, maybe I will replace this. But what's more concerning is the running capacitor, because this is the one that keeps the motor turning. Now, last but not least, let's move on to the centrifugal switch. So let me remove this. Okay, Allen wrench. One here as well. Okay. And this one, okay? Actually, you don't have to remove this. I'm just doing so just so I can show you much closer. So there's our switch. See that? Those contact points. See? Normally, it's in the closed position. So put your multimeter on the continuity test. Put one probe here and one probe here. Should I press down on that? It should beep. Should I release that? Okay, like I've shown earlier, it should stop beeping. Now, oftentimes when you plug in the motor and the motor doesn't turn, the culprit oftentimes becomes the starting capacitor. But like I've said, the centrifugal switch is what connects the starting capacitor. So you might want to check this as well, because there are times those contact points becomes burnt, okay? So don't underestimate the value of this. So it's not always the starting capacitor. Should you plug the motor in and the motor doesn't turn and it just hums or buzz, okay? But when you turn the rotor, it begins to turn. Oftentimes it's not really the starting capacitor, but it's really the centrifugal switch preventing the current to be transferred from here to here. That's why the starting capacitor fails to do its job. So all you need to do when that happens, okay, aside from the test that I've shown earlier, how to check the centrifugal switch, just get yourself a sandpaper, sandwich the sandpaper in between those contact points and just clean it like so. Okay, just like that. So anyway, I do believe we have covered everything. Just remember, when it comes to capacitor, the starting capacitor always has a higher capacitance than the running capacitor. So I would suggest you might just want to take a screenshot of this in order to guide you should you want to test your induction motor for yourself. Okay, dual capacitor, single phase induction motor. So there it is. It's all reassembled. Now, I do believe this is a useful skill to learn, okay? That way, should you have a problem with your dual capacitor single phase induction motor, you would know how to check it yourself. Because there are times, okay, should you bring this to a technician, they might lie to you, they might tell you that the motor is bad, that the winding is bad, that it needs to be rewound. But for all you know, it might just be a problem with the centrifugal switch or just the either the running capacitor or starting capacitor. But because you don't know how to check this, they might, okay, I'm not saying always, I'm not saying all of them, but there are some, they might make a fool out of you. So in this case, like I said, if you know how to check this, they can just fool you. Okay, so there it is again. Let's turn it on. And as you can see, it is working, okay? So anyway, I do believe that's it. That's all that there is to show. I hope you found this video helpful and informative. If you do, let me know in the comments below. And I would just like to reiterate what I said earlier in the beginning of this video. I'm just a DIYer, okay? I'm not a certified technician. So should you wish to emulate what you have seen here, do so at your own risk, okay? So I will end this video here. If you're new to my channel, like, share, subscribe if you want to, okay? Only if you want to. And may we all have a happy new year. And as always, thank you for watching.